Before we get to exactly how chronic bronchitis happens, I just want to review a quick rule of thumb about the body. So this is any opening the body has to the outside. Let's label this as the outside. And anytime you have an opening and irritants get into the body, it could be, by irritants I mean anything that doesn't belong there, that inflames the tissue. A common first defense of the body is to call on the glands, which are embedded in the tissue, to secrete either liquid or mucus into the space. And the goal is to have this fluid, this mucus, mix with the irritants and eventually flush them out or bring them out. I'm sure you can think of examples of what I'm talking about, like tears. If things get in your eye, it makes your eyes tear, right? So this is a mechanical thing. The tears actually flush out the irritant in your eye. And we have snot. Sorry, this is kind of gross, but if things get in your nose and it's not supposed to be there, the snot helps to bring it out. And a third thing, which has to do with what we're going to talk about today, is of course phlegm. So when things get into your throat or your lungs, the walls of the lungs secrete the mucus, which forms the phlegm. Now the system in the lungs also triggers a cough reflex, which, so the walls here, if you can see me drawing in red here, the walls here are lined with smooth muscle. And when the area is being irritated, the smooth muscle spasm, and that's how we get the cough reflex to bring the phlegm out. Now keep in mind, I said this is the body's first line of defense. So these are good things to have. You want the body to do this. So chronic bronchitis is basically too much of a good thing. So when we have overproduction of mucus, such that the body cannot clear it, too much of a good thing, that's when we have chronic bronchitis. And of course, itis just means it's being irritated. So, and bronch refers to the lungs. So chronic inflammation and irritation of the lungs. Alrighty, let's draw some airway. So we have our trachea. The big stem bronchus branch off into their branches. There you go, just keep going. There are 20 or 30 branches to this. You get the idea, they keep getting smaller and smaller. That's how our lungs expand. And as you know, oxygen goes into our lungs and carbon dioxide from the body gets out. So when you have irritants in there flooding what is usually a clear path, then the lungs are not going to like that. And one of the most common chronic irritants that we have in our lungs is, of course, cigarette smoking. So here we go, we're going to light this cigarette. And what you see as smoke rising from the cigarette, it's actually billions and billions of particles that can enter and lodge into our lungs. As a response, the glands in the side of the walls, they start secreting the mucus. Remember, it's part of our normal response to irritation. But of course, chronic, so we're talking about years and years of constant. Every day it's like this. Now eventually what's supposed to be a clear pathway becomes convoluted with the mucus. It's like if you're drinking through a straw from a cup, instead of having a clear straw, you're sucking on a milkshake. So this milkshake is thick and it's clogging the straw. So you have to suck harder and work harder to get through. Likewise, with the mucus, sometimes there's so much buildup that it can clog off one little branch of the lungs. So no more gas exchange can take place here. And depending on the severity of the disease, you can have different areas of the lungs being out of commission because of the mucus. Now, of course, we always talk about smoking, but there are other things that can lead to chronic bronchitis. One important thing is pollution. Again, pollutants are also billions of particles in the air all the time. And in some countries, that's an especially big problem, and chronic bronchitis is very common there. Or we can have coal dust for people who work in coal mines, or people who work with asbestos, shipyard workers. The common theme here is it happens when we can inhale irritants, and it happens every day. Now, if I just smoke for a few days and I have a lot of mucus, that doesn't qualify me for having chronic bronchitis. The pathophysiology here talks about the overgrowth of the glands, so we actually look for tissue change. Now, in a patient, to diagnose chronic bronchitis is usually a clinical diagnosis, which means there are no tests, it's just from the story. But we know from examining lungs of people who have passed away that tissue change actually happens. So I just blew up one branch of the airway here. We'll call this the lumen. The lumen just means the inside of the tube. So the lumen is here where the air is getting through. So the black space on both sides are the walls of the bronchi. So basically, if we take a cross section of our airway, in the middle here is the lumen. And right now I'm going to talk about the wall space of the bronchi. Okay, so we have some smooth muscle around the walls. Again, the spasm, and this is what gives us the cough reflex. And right near the surface, close to the lumen, we have these layers of glands. They're responsible for the mucus production we've been talking about. As you can see, they're right under the surface. The job is to secrete things into the lumen. Okay, just for completeness, let me draw some irritants in the lumen. Okay, so that's what a normal wall usually looks like. There's a way for us to put a number on this, and we've only seen this in people who have passed away, and their lungs get cut up in the lab, and we can look under the microscope to see the Reed index, which is a way to calculate the ratio of the glands, the thickness of the glands, to the whole wall. Now, a normal Reed index is less than 40%. So if you can see the thickness here versus the thickness of this whole wall, it should be less than 40% in you or me. And of course, in the middle here, there are other things like cartilage or connective tissue. I'm just going to fill it in a little bit. Now, what happens in chronic bronchitis is the actual thickness of the gland layer grows. So the glands start proliferating because we need so much mucus that the original number is not enough. So the body's recruited to make more glands and they extend towards the smooth muscle. So in chronic bronchitis, the Reed index is usually over 50%. So definitely more than half of the thickness of the whole wall is made of glands. Now remember, we cannot do this in living people because we have to cut away their lungs. So it's just a way for us to put a number on this disease, but usually patients are diagnosed and treated according to their symptoms. And the symptoms all come from this tissue change and the overproduction of mucus.